ना भाबू विद्यते सतः उभयूरपि दृष्टन्तः तु अनयुस्तत्तदर्शिभिः अविनाशी तु तद्विद्धि येन सर्वमिदं ततम् विनाशम् अभ्यस्य अस्य न कच्चित् कर्तुमर्हति क्रोधाद् भवति सन्मोहात् स्मृतिबिभ्रमः स्मृतिर्भ्रंशात् बुद्धिनाशु बुद्धिनाशात् प्रणश्यति कर्मण्येवाधिकारस्ते मा फलेषु कदाचन मा कर्मफलहेतुर्भुर्मा ते सङ्गु अस्तकर्मणि ॐ शान्ति 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 थैंक यू
थैंक यू मधुमिता दैट वाज इंडीड अ वेरी ब्यूटीफुल वे टू स्टार्ट आवर प्रोग्राम वी वुड नाउ लाइक टू इनवाइट डॉक्टर निवेदिता फुकन प्रिंसिपल एम AG College, some address. Madam Phukan, please.
Thank you. A very good morning to you all. I congratulate you all on this National Librarians Day. At the very outset, I would like to pay tribute to the great librarian of India. Voice to nice one again. Can you hear me? Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
Okay.
Yes, okay.
A very good morning to you all. I congratulate you all on National Librarians Day. At the very outset, I would like to pay tribute to the great librarian of India, Shyali Ramamrita Ranganathan, on this special day. The mathematician, author, academic, and librarian was born on 9th August 1892, as written by him in his book, recognized. Can you hear me?
Yes, please go ahead.
Okay, thank you.
Yes, we can.
Libraries are the fountains of knowledge and learning around the world. They are the home to all the world's written records and works, as well as other forms of media, such as films, CDs, videotapes, DVDs, Blu-ray discs, maps, e-books, audiobooks, and databases. Libraries in academic institutions play a pivotal role to create an environment to help students to imbibe the reading culture. Along with attending their classes, students need to develop intensive and extensive reading habits to become a good student as well as a good reader and knowledgeable person. It is believed that all Kuara Wiwin Library is the oldest library in the world. It was a part of the oldest universities and was first opened in 1859 CE. It was founded by Fatima Al-Fihri, the daughter of a wealthy Tunisian merchant. The Library of Congress is the National Library of the United States and the largest library in the world, having working and operating in different countries like India, Pakistan, Indonesia, Brazil, and Nairobi. The biggest library in India is the National Library, Calcutta. It is a great pleasure for the readers and visitors to visit these libraries. It happens to be a lifetime experience for any readers. This particular web talk is jointly organized by the Dibrugarh College Central Library and Monohari Devi Kanoi Girls College Library on the occasion of celebration of Librarians Day, 12th August 2020. What happened? Dr. S. R. Ranganathan was alive today. Here, I welcome Dr. Jitu Buraguhai, the inaugurator of this web talk of Dibrugarh College, Dibrugarh, and I would like to welcome our chief guest, Professor Ramesh C. Gaur, Dean and Director of Kala Nidhi Division, Indira Gandhi National Center for the Arts, IGNCA, Ministry of Culture, Government of India. I welcome all the panelists and the participants of this web talk and hope it will be a great benefit for them. Thank you all. Hello.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you.
Address. Now, may I invite Dr. of Principal of Dibrugarh College to please give the inaugural speech. I think there is a small technical issues. We have not been able to connect to Dr. Jitu Buraguhai, sir. Please bear with us. I'm sorry for the delay. Could you just give us a few seconds so we get connected to Principal, sir? So, yes. You please give your inaugural speech.
Okay, thank you. I'm sorry, little bit of hassles here. Okay, Hey, good morning and welcome to all of you. Respected Professor Ramesh C. Gore, my faculty colleagues, respected faculty colleagues of both the colleges, although I am saying that it is a faculty college, so of both the faculty colleges of both the colleges, MDKG College and Dubuque College, esteemed participants and my dear students. Welcome to all of you again to the webinar on a very important talk. What would have happened had S.R. Ranganathan, Professor S.R. Ranganathan was alive today? Although it's a little bit hypothetical topic, yeah. But I'm going later for it, yeah. It is often said that what Newton was to physics, Dr. Ranganathan was to library science, definitely. But Newton's effort went only to extend the frontiers of the already well-established discipline. On the other hand, Ranganathan's effort helped to create a new discipline not existed previously or existed only as a nebulous concept. Ranganathan had a long and immensely productive career in librarianship, during the course of which he expounded articulately and with continued, consistent passion on almost every aspect of the profession, from reference service to public library legislation, and from cataloging standards to international cooperations. The whole philosophy of Ranganathan seems to anticipate modern development in the librarianship, especially those developments brought out by advances in technology. Future generations of librarians may well look upon Ranganathan as a towering figure in pre- and post-automation eras in librarianship. Right from its inception of INSDOC, the Indian National Scientific Documentation Center, which was founded in 1952, Professor Ranganathan was the founder and the chairman of the first advisory committee. Professor Ranganathan had made immense contribution in shaping the programs and policies of INSDOC. He also the founder editor of Annals of Library Science and Documentation. The 21st century has witnessed a great increase in information management and transmission. The new information age has brought about improved knowledge delivery, processing of information, precision, good time management, and improved network systems. Furthermore, information is called data, and databases are created and made accessible online via the internet and machine-readable programs. The library today is a technologically driven one that uses the principle of traditional library services to organize knowledge and communicate to the users, essentially by electronic means. Despite the beautiful development, there exist basic challenges that tend to hinder the provision of access to knowledge by library. Many library and staff tend to have an apathetic attitude towards work. They are not committed to client-oriented service. Lack of maintenance culture renders infrastructure and equipment like ICT facilities non-functional and poor funding. There shall be training and retaining of librarians, staff in the area of computer technology and management infrastructure services. The institution and librarians, library managers, be committed and should work round the clock to ensure the ICT and facilities are maintained regularly. Although, as I said earlier, that our topic of discussion seems to be hypothetical, but I believe it will underline the contribution and dedication of S.R. Ranganathan. It will underline the relevance of Ranganathan in 21st century. It it will underline the role of libraries in the 21st century digital age. I sincerely believe that we have a very highly influenced, highly intellectual person, that is Professor Sigur, who will look into the issues very critically and will make the talk very, very interesting and important. With these few words, I once again welcome all of you, and very good morning to all of you again. Over to Nandita. Nandita.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
For already giving us an idea about the talk that we are going to hear today. Next we have is Mr. Jadav Jyoti Hoike, librarian of MDKG College, who will give a brief sketch of Dr. S.R.
Ranganathan. Very good. A very big good morning to everybody present in this webinar. It is our privilege to celebrate the National Librarians Day on the occasion of 120th anniversary of Padma Shri S.R. Ranganathan on 12th of August. I want to sketch very briefly on the life of S.R. Ranganathan, both personal and professional. I thank you, Dr. Jitu Buragoin sir, for highlighting some points about his contribution to library science. And I would like to contribute my presentation purely on his chronological life sketch of his illustrious career of librarianship. Sri Ramamitra Ranganathan was born in 1892 in Thanjavur district, Tamil Nadu, to a IR Brahmin family. He passes matriculation in 1908 and completes MA in mathematics in 1916 as the only student of Professor Edward B. Rose. Then he starts his career as a teaching faculty in various colleges and lastly joined Presidency College in Madras in 1921. In those days, he develops his love for books and engages himself in some library activities, right from selecting books and arranging them. Till 1923, there was no post as university librarian in universities in India. Madras University was the first to advertise for the post of university librarian in 1923. And Ranganathan was forced by some of his friends to apply for the post because of his love for books. He got appointment in 1924 and he went to University College of London to join the School of Librarianship for formal education in library science and come back in 1925. In 1928, he became able to arrange the library at Madras University to some extent. He was very unhappy with the existing procedures prevailed in India at the time. He wants to bring many original concepts to librarianship. In 1928, he formulates 5 laws of library science, which is equivalent to Newtonian's law of physical science. The law was remain unchallenged till date. Who witnessed that he desires to get help from his mother subject mathematics while developing various laws and procedures in library science. His teachers, mainly Edward Rose, helps him in developing the first law, saying that for you, books are for use. Then come the other laws. Every reader his or her book, every book to its reader, every time, save the time of the reader, and lastly, library is a growing organism. He published 5 laws of library science in 1931, designs the classified catalog code in 1934, brings out Polygamonathu library classification in 1937, the Bible of all library classification. He designs chain indexing in 1938. He develops keen desire to establish library school in India since 1925 and establishes first library school in Madras in 1929. He joins Banaras Hindu University as university librarian in 1945 and establishes diploma course in library science. In 1947, he joins Delhi University as professor of library science, and in 1948, starts bachelor of library science and establishes library Indian Library Association, brings out a regular, the periodical of Indian Library Association. In 1950, he starts master of library science in Delhi University, first of its kind among Commonwealth nations at that time. In 1962, he establishes DRTC, Documentation and Research Training Center, with the help of Indian Statistical Institution. He was engaged actively with various organizations in India and abroad. He was engaged in various GOV initiatives for developing libraries, in bringing out library acts and formulating policies and developing library movement in India. Ranganathan was a genius and introduces many original concepts towards librarianship. He laid postulation approach to library classification. The 5 laws of library science is based on normative principles. His chain indexing, facet analysis, mnemonic principles are results of his conceptual framework. After spending a glorious career of about 50 years, library Ranganathan passes away in 1972 at Bangalore. I want to share two facts, both fascinating and motivating about him. The first one is that he did not take a leave, that he will leave even casual leave on his marriage day with Sarada Ranganathan, his second wife. The second one is that he establishes Sarada royalties and his salaries as national professor. Here I conclude and I offer my tribute to S. R. Ranganathan and welcomes all the participants and guests to this webinar. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Jadav Jyoti Sargya. It was wonderful listening to his life sketch. Ranganathan was indeed a genius who conceived library science long back. And today, as we all know, our talk is on what would have happened if Dr. S. R. Ranganathan was alive today. And I feel very privileged because the talk is being delivered by a very eminent person, Dr. Ramesh Chandra Gaur, Dean, Director, Library and Information, and Head of Kalanidhi Division at the Indira Gandhi National Center for Arts, New Delhi, under Ministry of Culture. He did his early education in Delhi and completed his master's from Annamalai University and his PhD from Dr. V. R. A. University, Agra. He is a recipient of Fulbright Fellowship in Information Science and Technology in 2002. He had various assignments in different libraries and has also worked as librarian of Jawaharlal Nehru University, Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, Management Development Institute, IMT, Ghaziabad, and many more such well-known libraries. He is a member of Expert Consultation Committee and International Center for Documentary Heritage in South Korea, member of UGC Draft Regulation Committee of Plagiarism, International Federation of Library Association, and many more such associations. The list would go on and on. He has conducted over 100 workshops on plagiarism, its detection and avoidance. He has a great contribution in digital achieving of Indian cultural heritage, preserving of Indian language. He has received many awards, both nationally and internationally. Recognition of his work is as a member of many international committees too. He has many research papers, published a number of books too. Participants, we are very, very happy to have with us Dr. Ramesh Chandra Gaur. Sir, we are eagerly waiting to hear from you the talk on Dr. S.R. Ranganathan, that what would have been if he was alive today. So the microphone is over to you.
Thank you, Dr. Nandita Vishya, for your kind introduction. It's indeed a great honor. Let me first congratulate and thanks Dr. Jitendra Burgan and Dr. Nivedita Phukan, principal of MDK College, and Dr. Jitu, principal of Dibru College, for organizing this event on this very, very important day. And thank you for
Sir, we are unable to hear you. Can you please unmute yourself?
Yeah, please. Oh, sorry. I didn't realize it that. So thank you. Let me express my sincere thanks to Dr. Jitu Burgoyne, a principal Dibru College, and Dr. Nivedita Phukan, a principal MDK College, MDKG College, for organizing this event on such an important day. And also thanks for inviting me. And let me start by wishing you all a happy Librarians Day and also happy Sri Krishna Janmashtami. You know, today is a festival of birthday celebrations of Lord Krishna. And that's why I was a little hesitant in accepting this invitation, but Deepika and Jyoti, they didn't allow me to skip this event, and they forced me, no, you have to be here. So it's an honor with all of you, and I'm so glad the Dr. Jitu has put up a right tone for this important day by giving a wonderful narrative on a great Dr. Ranganathan. The kind of comparison he made with the contribution of Newton and Dr. Ranganathan is heart-touching, and we really feel proud and glad that he thought of so high of librarians community. Thank you, Dr. Burgain, for your wonderful and very, very nice compliments and a very, very good introduction to his contributions and this personality. Definitely, Jadav Jyoti has given you a wonderful account of his life sketches, how he started his career, and how he become the great. So I'm not going to talk on Ranganathan because it's enough literature available. There are number of events taking place, and so many people will be talking about his life and work. Basically, the topic when Deepika talked to me and wants to know what topic I should speak and why I chosen this topic. There's some reasons for it. I will explain to you why I suggested this topic for today's birthday celebration. I have some PPT also, but before that, I would prefer to speak something from my heart. There is no doubt, whatever librarianship today, it is because of contribution of truly father of library science, Dr. S.R. Ranganathan. he like Jadhav Jyoti mentioned that some of his friends asked him to apply for the position. Yeah, that was the one of the reason. But another reason was that that time the position which he was carrying, the lecturer position, the university librarian position was respectable and higher than that of a lecturer. So in that time also, the university librarian position was one of the very reputed and very important position in the university. So he made a beginning, and after that he never looks back. He contributed nationally and internationally. His persona, you can imagine like that. Somewhere in 2000, American Library Association compiled the list of top 100 librarians in USA. And instead of compiling 100 librarians, they compiled list of 101 librarians. And do you know, Ranganathan was the 101 librarian in that list. And the narrative was that, although Dr. Ranganathan does not belong to US, but he has contributed so much to the librarianship, global librarianship, that we consider him as one of the main contributor of library movement in the US. So that was his persona. So that contribution, nobody can doubt about it in the field of library science. But more than library science, his administrative and leadership qualities. He became the first national research professor of UGC. He able to start so many institutes, so many department, and so many courses all over India. He's a founder of so many institutions and programs and associations. How he is able to do it? What the passion what he has about the librarianship? So that was something which he did it wonderfully, and he created positions, he created education, he created a kind of important perception about librarianship in the mind of academicians and administrator of that time. So that persona which gives us everything what we are seeing today. In last 20, 30 years, maybe 30 years, I will say 30 years, whatever hard work he has done, I think we are not able to sustain the work he has done. Why? If he has alive today, what happens? He must be in very pains. He must be feeling very disappointed. Firstly, and lastly also, with the library community, the librarians. He given you everything in the plate, and you are supposed to take it forward only, and you are not able to do it. There are a number of reasons. I can speak day and nights on this topic, that why we are not able to do it. But what are the most important reason? What if he would have alive, what he would have done in this situation? Like, what is happening? Like, currently, the society, the administrator, the educator, the policy maker, I think they have certain kind of mindset. They have start believing that now everything is available on internet. What is the need of the library? This is killing library. This is downgrading positions. This is not allowing to fill up the positions. 75% of the post of university librarians, college librarian, and school librarians are vacant in this country. Whom to blame for it? Why people are not understanding that we need a librarian for the college or school or university? Why people positions have been given to making in charge of different subject? Because of these mindset. So the most important problem what libraries are facing today, it is the perception and the mindset of the people who are running the libraries. who are managing the library, who are managing the education institution, who are managing the different kind of libraries. It may be a research library, it may be. He started positions of scientist in CSIR system. When he was in his doc, he is able to, that all the librarians were considered scientists, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, equivalent to the other scientist. And now what is the scenario? The position has downgraded to technical officer. He talked about very high in terms of having very motivated young professionals, highly skilled professionals. And what is happening? Like now there are so many professionals, but there are no jobs. And it is because of internet. Yes, media has changed. Internet has affected each and every component of the life. Why we should, you should just think that it has affected libraries only. So the most important problem today librarians are facing is that people are not aware of it. If they are aware, they are not convinced it. If they are, like when I was in Manipur sometime last year, there was a statement made by one of the minister, like everything is available on internet. What is the need of libraries? So these kind of situations, we need at least 4 lakh libraries, and we have only public libraries, and we have only 46,000 public libraries in this country. We need to have a library in each panchayat. We have 2.45 lakhs panchayat. Notice, where are those panchayat libraries? So what is happening? This is the biggest issue. And to take care of this, librarianship is not having voice. We are having a leadership crisis. Why this leadership crisis? So I want to say two things on this. If he would have alive, what he would have done? He would have gone to the government. He would have gone to the policymakers. He would have gone to the public. He could have created a movement to convince the authorities that libraries are required now more than ever. I'm saying same thing in every platform, but I'm not Ranganathan. Because to be a Ranganathan, you need a kind of persona, the people's mindset. So if Ranganathan would have said it, it could have make an impact on the minds of the people, or society, public, policymaker, and we should have done something good for this profession, and these situations should not have arisen. Now, second important point, why we don't have any Ranganathan? Ranganathan will never come back. Gandhiji has never come back. Still, country is running. We have great leaders. We have one of the finest prime minister, Mr. Narendra Modi. So, no great leader come back. Same, the Ranganathan will never come back. So we have to learn, and we have to learn how to develop leadership. There are a number of people who have immensely contributed in this library field. But the problem, we have a divided profession. We have so much infighting within the system that we are not ready to accept anybody as our leader. Although somebody might have contributed significantly, may not be equivalent to Ranganathan, but greatly in current situation. So if he would have alived, he should have asked librarians to learn to respect your leaders, choose your leaders. Everybody cannot be leader. The people who deserve, who have merit, who have contributed, should be selected as a leader. And without leader, there is no profession growth. There is no direction to the profession. So these are the two things he should have done in case of current situation of a kind of problem in the library profession. The second important point which I will highlight in my presentation about the technology. How technology is affecting us, and how we should change ourselves to deal with the technological developments. I will give you some example that how we should deal with the technological developments in my presentation. I will open the slide soon and I will give you. Now, third important thing he should have done if he is alive, that librarians should change according to the needs. Librarians should develop themselves according to the needs of the society. They should understand the current needs of the users. He always considered user as a god, customer as a god. Same philosophy of Gandhiji and Dr. Ranganath. So he should have given you a kind of direction that develop your facility, services and resources according to the needs of the user. He was a great supporter of the need. Now take example, in this current corona situation, what he would have done? You remember he introduced the concept of the bullet card libraries. Why that concept of bullet card libraries? Because there was no technology. Today you have technology, remote access and discovery. Your resources can be accessed anywhere, anytime. There was no digitization. So how he talked to reach out the people? He given an innovative idea to reaching out people with the bullet cart libraries. Later some public libraries have introduced mobile van or mobile bus libraries. But that was the best idea in this particular current situation and timing. So in this corona situation, COVID-19, when the education institutions are closed, where libraries are closed, what he would have suggested, what he would have done? He would have asked librarians to go to the people, reach out to the people and provide them services, whatever they need, wherever they are. He should have talked about the principle of reaching out to the people. And now, luckily, we have technology. We can reach out to people very easily. So that should have been his other approach in reaching out to people. One thing which he never faced in his life, actually, he was the undisputed leader. There was no parallel people or the kind of competition or kind of like equivalent positions in the field. He was the sole leader and everybody was listening to him. People were not there to pull his leg. People were not there to criticize him. People were not there to find fault in him. So I can tell you that even Ranganathan would have faced a tremendous challenge in promoting his ideas and principles and theories. I'm saying this based on my experiences, that if he would have alived, he would also have faced the challenges which people like us are facing in today's situation. But I'm sure the great leader he was, he could have found out a better way which we may not be able to find. We may be trying best in our field, but still that leadership role, what he has done, he was able to create those positions with this government. Now it is very difficult to even get the position, backend position filled up. There was no library association that time. Now there are so many library associations, but they are not able to get that done which he was able to do it alone. He was able to create post in government system and very senior level positions, but we are not able to fulfill those positions which are already created. Many of the positions are being downgraded or not filled, or somebody else is appointed. A person with no library science background is appointed a director of some center or head of a library or in charge of a library. I'm not against any individual. Everybody has their own way of dealing with the situations. So I think he would have find out some ways, and this is our responsibility to similarly find out some ways and means. We have a new education policy. It's an excellent policy. But what? Where is the libraries in this? What? Where is the role of libraries? There is a National Research Foundation has been proposed. Now, when we are proposing setting up National Research Foundation, do you think there is a research possible without libraries? So, is there any mention of libraries in it? I can challenge and I can guarantee to the all policymakers and the researcher in the world, without libraries, no research possible. You cannot move one place to another place without having information in place. So you, when you cannot develop your libraries, when you can see why India is number 5 in terms of research output, but we are not even top 20 in terms of quality research. Why we are not there? Why our average citation score is not less than 1? Is less than 1? Why it is there? Because it is not problem of having a National Research Foundation or having a multiple agencies for funding support. It is a problem of really understanding how research is being done in this country, how PhDs are awarded, how topics are selected, what is the monitoring system after giving, like, and there is so much duplication of research. So we have no mention of libraries. We are talking about culture, we are talking about each and every aspect in this new education policy, but we are not telling even a single line about role of libraries in education. In our ancient time, talk about Nalanda University, talk about Gurukul system, whatever you talk about it, there is no education without libraries in that time also. So what librarians are doing now? Are we going, are we talking to the government, are we meeting them, telling them, sir, please understand, no research is possible without libraries. And if you neglect libraries, if you don't provide support, you don't fill up the positions, you don't provide leadership role to the libraries, how the libraries can develop? And if libraries cannot develop, I can say you can bring out a new education policy, you can bring out anything. If you cannot improve your library information services, you cannot do quality research. Go to any part of the world. I have traveled across the world. The library is one of the most important component of research. Our first president, Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan, very clearly, he clearly mentioned that libraries are heart of academic institution. But this heart is now sinking. The heart is sinking and we are not understanding that. So we have to really understand those nitty-gritty of, and if he would have arrived, so what he would have done? He should have gone to the government, he should have talked to the policymakers, say, gentlemen, your national education policy is very good, but you need to relook. You need to redefine the role of libraries in this national education policy. And if you cannot define the role of libraries in education policy, you cannot think of improving the current state of libraries or current state of education without giving complete focus on the libraries. So, last thing in my oral presentation, I would like to touch upon. The kind of reading habit going down and down. Our students, our kids, they are more aligned to computer. The computer is a very good tool. Internet is an excellent platform. You read in online form or offline form, but you must read. Reading habits are going down and down. People are not feeling importance of the library. So there's something wrong in our efforts in creating awareness about the libraries. There is a clear-cut studies where it is very well mentioned that you read more, you publish more. So why we are not giving that much focus on reading, enhancing reading? We should start from the school level. Our school libraries are so bad. Like, talk about the rural areas. I remember sometime back last year when this previous government in Uttar Pradesh, there was a circular was issued that physical education teachers will be in charge of the libraries. You are not understanding what the librarians do in a school library. What is the role of a school librarian? A person, you cannot ask an engineer to operate a patient in hospital. Putting somebody else in place of librarian is just like you are putting an engineer to do operation of a patient. He may be excellent engineer. I don't have any doubt about it. So the job assignment responsibilities comes with the knowledge, with the education. So let me just share my presentation to further talk on some other issues which I would like to highlight in this in a different way. So see, basically you all know these are the five laws of Ranganathan. Books are for use, every person is a book, every book is reader, save the time of the reader, a library is a growing organism. We all know that. So I think there is no doubt about the importance and relevance of these laws. Now, when we talk about current situation, this OCLC is one of the largest and the biggest organization in terms of library research. So what they have done a few years before, they have done reordering Ranganathan. Can you believe it? Ranganathan is so relevant. I travel across the world, and whenever I go somewhere, people ask what is the status of his works and who is forwarding, who is taking it, carrying it. So you can imagine the organization like OCLC is still finding Ranganathan's law as relevant. So what was the Ranganathan's original conception of first law? Books are for use. And now new conception in current environment defined under that is e-books are for use. Netflix is for watching. Blackboard is for studying. So in current pandemic situation, you must have realized that now there is a very important need of online learning teaching tools. So that's why this reordering, although it is a pre-COVID reordering, but Blackboard is okay. Similarly, every person his or her book, every listener had iTunes, every artist this his photograph, every student her EasyBib account, means in research you have to do citation. So now basically you have to really connect your and even you can make a book to the ebook or e-library. Similarly, ebook it's reader, every book it's reader, every blog it's reader, every Twitter account is reader, every Facebook read post is reader, every internet every open access journal is reader, every Google Maps traveler, every digital response repositories researcher. Save the time of the reader, save the time of the listener, save the time of the traveler, save the time of the researcher. So it is not just about book reading. It is all about information in print, online, over the internet, or in any other platform. So definitely in this current time, if Ranganathan would have alive, he himself has changed these laws. He himself has modified these laws like that. So like when we talk about save the time of the readers, now what are the technologies available? How you save the time of the readers? Now you have digital technologies, and you can implement technologies like remote access or discovery, and you can integrate all the website, all the kind of library OPAC and other thing in providing single window search. So in that way you will be saving the time of the reader, because reader can search everything in one go. So that's the one thing. Second is how to provide information to the user by email or by in form of putting in a searchable databases. So that way you are saving time of the reader. Now another important thing is that how to help reader in searching and the evaluation of information, because user priorities are changing. So how to help user? So there are multiple ways now libraries can save the time of the user. It is not just library services, but reference services, virtual reference services, research support services. By providing various kind of personalized services, you can save the time of the reader. Similarly, when you talk about searching facilities, now this is a time where meta search, like what I am talking about, the BEV scale discovery. This BEV scale discovery is something single window search like Google, and by doing you can change the search mechanism, delivery mechanism, discovery mechanism by according to the needs of the user. So that's the way you can save the time of the users. Now every person has his or her book. Now it is not just book. We have multimedia formats. We have articles in electronic form, in database, in journal, in blog, in Twitter, on a social media platform. So the information is being created at many places. So when we are searching for information, we need to learn how to search the most relevant information for the most right user. So now it is not just about a ebook or book or a journal. It is about information in multimedia format. So when you are searching on internet, you will be definitely having so there are many different groups in research community, and each has different culture, approaches and methods. Not all disciplines share the same language, concept of or ideals. The culture of discipline dictates how and what information or is shared, stored, reported. So it's more about search, research, sharing, reuse kind of information. So you have to really understand your community, and you have to provide the information accordingly. Books are for use. So whatever information is created on internet, whatever information is created in print, non-print, electronic, audio, video, every information has certain users. So we have to look into that complex information environment, and we have to really, really, really think of providing this important information to them. And when we talk about e-contents, so we need to understand that these e-contents improve access, and librarians must increasingly consider a great variety of digital formats and content. This goes beyond the e-journal revolution to include the curation of data sets and the providing emerging services, as a virtual research environment, open source material, non-text based and multimedia objects, blogs and digital resources which have not been envisaged. So librarian has to expand their horizon. Their area is not just books and journals. They have to expand their area according to the current user behavior, because user want information not just in published books and article. He or she want information all over scattered in many places. Every book its reader. So whatever information has been created, it has some reader. So library has to build their workflow around the library. It must reach out the workflow its users are creating on the network. So basically you have to connect your users with various services, with the various facilities, so they can make use of the things. Now a library is a growing organism, means it is increasing by number of publications. So now this has totally replaced, the new concept is web is a growing organism. And now on web, anyone can publish and does whatever information they want. So librarians can play an important role in weeding through the dross and establishing annotated list of links that patrons can feel confident about using. Give you an example, like we have a World Wide Web, and how we search that? Using Google. So we need to educate our researchers about this Google trustworthiness. We need to educate our users. Google or any standard search engines provide access to just 15 to 20% BAP contents. Rest 80 to 85% BAP contents are not accessed by the Google. So how to access those 80 to 85% BAP contents? Which is called deep web. Second point about Google, we should educate our users. Librarians should understand and they should educate the user. Google search does not certify the authenticity of the information. It's a huge web, but everything is not genuine. Everything is not authenticated. There are fake information. There is a unwanted information. There is a wrong information. There is information for to how to create suicide, how to commit suicide. There is information how to make a bomb. There is information how to, and there is some kind of fake information. Lot of bombarding of fake information or fake news. So Google will not help you in that. While searching on Google, you may not get most relevant result higher up in relevancy or ranking. When you are searching on Google or any standard search engine, the first result may not be the most relevant result what you want. So how to really you got the best result? Because in this slide I was searching best open access journal and result was Omics International. So there is information overload. So how to deal with this information load? Internet is huge, but internet is not a library or even not a digital library. So you need to convince and educate your users and those policy makers, the administrators, that internet has many things, but everything is not useful for research. Everything is not useful for your academic activities. You need to have a right information in a right manner. Not just everything. You need relevant things, not all kind of information. So in that way, you need to educate the user. This web is huge. It is divided into three major components: surface web, deep web, and dark web. A surface web is which you search through Google and other standard search engines like Yahoo, etc. Deep web is something which is academic information, government information. Dark web is illegal porn, illegal information, encrypted sites, and other domain which you cannot enter without a license or something like that. So this deep web, which contains a lot of academic and government information, how to penetrate that? Ranganathan could have find out ways if he has arrived, and he should have focused on this area, that how to reach out this deep web. This deep web size is huge. It is 200,000 times. Unfortunately, our librarians are not focusing on it. Even they are not aware of it. I keeps on talking on these issues, but I have hardly seen somebody is aware of all those things. So first, librarians need to educate themselves, and then they need to educate the researcher and students about how to search deep web. There are just certain kind of meta search engines like Web Scale Discovery and Predatory Search. And in that way, the first thing they should do it, they should club together all the library resources. So instead of user is going one place and another place, he or she can search library catalog, journal databases, institutional repository, ebooks, online databases, and open access resources in one single window search. And that way you can retrieve all the information and you can be selective. Here you will search only authenticated information, not unwanted information. Similarly, to search deep web, there are a number of search engines designed by the various our researcher. Ranganathan developed the various kind of search system, pre-index and post-coordinate indexing system, POPSI. How have you done anything new, innovative, and some research? No, we have not done, but there is enough work done by the researcher all over the world. So there are certain kind of databases, semantic search tool databases, meta search engines, journal search engines and databases, academic search engines and databases like Google Scholar, scientific search engines and databases like GoPubMed, collaborative information and databases like Delicious, open access search engines like Core. So Ranganathan, if he would have alive, he must have understood the challenges of web and he should have developed some more indigenized system of dealing with this kind of complications. And I'm not asking you to develop those kind of such tools. I'm only asking you to make use of the existing resources, the facilities created to deal with this kind of situation. Ranganathan's soul will be very happy to see that at least our librarians are making some efforts. Apart from that, I think we need to change the impression about libraries. We need to really give a good overview to the policymaker, to the public. Actually, public support is very important. We have not utilized public support. So whatever image today we have, we need to make an image makeover. We also need to enhance the quality of education. He created so many library science schools. Now, there is so much distance learning colleges in schools. Do we need so much distance learning? There are a number of points on education. Syllabus need to be changed. What we are teaching is only 10 to 20% is relevant for the practical library activities. So why we are not developing syllabus which is practical oriented? Because library science is a technical and very, very scientific course. It is a science. So we need to deal with the science. And we also need to understand that IT is important, but we should not give too much focus on IT only. We should also think of developing certain kind of services, attitude to provide good services. The service is the most important for a user. Technology is required to provide the service, but first you have to think of providing good services. Definitely we are having a divided profession. ILA, ISLIC have lost relevant. There is a too many regional level individual association. So we need to work hard to bring out and to show profession, to work for the unity of the profession. And if we don't do, Ranganathan's would be in pain by seeing this kind of situation which is happening in this country. Libraries are still extremely important. This is something I want to tell you. Ranganathan would have advised you that everything available on internet is not authenticated. Internet is not a digital library. Library is not about just books. Just like any business, computers are everywhere. So why you are so worried about that? You need to understand that libraries are the institution which are repository of our social development, and no sustainable development is possible. And we need to, that internet is in mess. Librarians are the modern search engines. They can deal it very, very well. So libraries are providing most relevant and most authenticated information. And another thing, in a country like India, still internet is not reached everywhere. We have very few percentage of people who have internet. So still, and everybody cannot buy such a costly books. So libraries are more relevant and will remain relevant. We also need to understand that we should learn how to resolve these leadership issues. We should make clear that without leadership, no profession can progress. We need to develop future leaders. Every librarian, successful librarian, has to develop his team, to encourage his staff and support people. Librarians need to understand there is no hard substitute for hard work, sincerity and punctuality. Avoid politics, conflict and dishonesty. Create a good image among the people. And the current focus of library expertise is how to search, what to search and what not to search on internet. How to differentiate between good quality open access resources on internet and fake information or authentic information. Librarians should develop expertise. Recently I did a webinar on this and there was a very much interest among the people on this particular topic. How to deal with information overload means how to search on deep web. Education 4.0, we need to design our libraries according to need of the education 4.0, according to the need of new education policy. We need to focus on research support services. We need to provide remote access and discovery services, because you have to reach out to the user where they are. We need to develop facilities for persons with disabilities. We need to think of community. If you don't have any public library, open your college library for public. if you have a university library, open library. See, community need to be developed. Without education, without library, without libraries, no education. Without libraries, no information. And need to preserve our contents by digitizing and digital archiving. Information and media literacy, e-research literacy is very important. Need to develop subject gateways and subject guide. And we should learn what are the best technologies available to help us in that. So these were the few of my thoughts. My dear friends, my fellow librarians, Ranganathan will never come back. We should not think of that also. No great leaders have come back, but communities, societies, countries go and do well. We have to identify a Ranganathan within our own community. There are good people, there are good leaders. You must identify them, give them good respect. Ranganathan would have done the same thing. He was a very, very good person in promoting future leaders. He encouraged many people who become very good in their fields. Similarly, we need to encourage people. We need to give respect to the people who are doing well in this profession. So I think he would have arrived. Definitely, he must have been in pain. But at the same time, he should not have given up. He must have tried hard to bring out this librarianship from current state to the better position. So I think these are some of my thoughts, and my true homage to Dr. Ranganathan is that Ranganathan did his work. Now we have to do our own work. He shown us path. He given us direction. He developed a platform. Now it is our turn. It is our duty. He also faced the challenges. Now you see what you think can be the biggest challenge when nobody knows about librarianship and he is able to develop so good blueprint and such a good program for librarianship. We have so much in place. We need to only convince people. We need to only educate people that libraries and librarians are required now more than ever to deal with this complexity of internet, to deal with the complexity of multimedia format, this complexity of reading habit is going down and down. Quality of research is going down and down. 1980, India was top 10 countries in terms of original research. We need to think. We need to analyze. This country need to think that why we are not even top 30 countries of in terms of original research. Although we have done wonderfully well in terms of publishing more papers. Why our papers are not getting good citations? Why we are having a average citation score less than one, which is less than a small country like South Korea. There are a number of things which we need to think over it. And I'm sure we all are capable of doing it. Have confidence in yourself. Like the way I have heard this young man, Jadhav Jyoti, the way he beautifully presented about Ranganathan, it is remarkable. A youngster, like I've seen Deepika is doing wonderfully in terms of, I believe he's having some journal also. And so this youngster have desire and willingness to do something good. We need to enhance the interest of those such youngster and also to encourage them. So my heartfelt homage to my great idol, the father of library science, Dr. Ranganathan, we are indebted to you. We are thankful to you for your wonderful contribution. May your soul rest in peace and bless us and bless this profession. You were a passionate librarian. And being a passionate librarian, the most important thing, you live for the profession, you die for the profession. I think your soul must motivate thousands and lakhs of the professionals in this country. With these words, thank you very much, and thank all the authorities and the librarians for organizing this very important program on this important days. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for that very beautiful presentation. So you have also mentioned some very pertinent question, and that is about the role of library in the educational system and in the educational policy. It seems that library is not very high up where educational policy reformation is considered. And you also mentioned that library is about growing organism, but somehow it seems it has come to a very slow development. We also liked your wonderful comparison of books are for use, and now we have ebooks, Netflix, every book sits reader, and now we have Google Map, and so on. So we have a few questions from our participants, which we would like you to answer. The first question we have is, we have seen that Library Association at national level have failed to highlight the importance of libraries before the policy makers, and as a result, our issues have not been included in the national policy of education. We need a very active one platform to raise our issues collectively to achieve our goal. What is your views? And we need people like you to initiate the movement. Do you think all library associations should come together and have a very dynamic coordinator taking this movement forward? Your views, please, sir.
Thank you. Very important and very relevant question. I wish your suggestion, what you have proposed, if it is done, it is the ideal solution to move forward. But unfortunately, many times, because of personal egos, because of conflicts of interest, we fail to have a single platform. Here, it's not about the platform. Actually, it is about us. Why we are allowing a national library to not to take our jobs? Why we are not? We are the member of that library association. Why we are not raising voice? So first important thing for all of us is that first we should understand our roles and responsibilities. We should not worry about somebody will feel happy or not. We should raise voice. We should learn how to ask questions. And these questions may be asked to the library association, the people who are running the library association, the government, why the libraries are not given due representation in national education policy. Maybe the society, maybe the authorities. When IIT Bombay position was downgraded from professor to a junior level position. And unfortunately, we are not asking questions. We are not asking question if a vice chancellor is not appointing a university librarian for years. We are not asking question to the secretary culture that why center secretary library has not been filled up from last 10 years. Problem is that we are not asking questions. We hesitate. We thought somebody else will come and sort out our issues and problems. But that never happened. Actually, without waiting that some association will take matter, it is the responsibility of all of us to come together and take lead and start a movement. And that movement may be small. Like, take example of Anna Hazare. He was a single individual. But one point of time, he totally put this country in a one thought that we need to fight with the corruption. The single individual makes the entire difference. Although it's another debate that how much was successful or not, but the way he created a movement, somewhere down the line, libraries need to create a movement. We only fight for our salaries and pay scales and retirement age, but we never fight for our libraries. Actually, this Librarians Day should be Libraries Day. It should be today's day should have been designated. If I am in place, I should have said Libraries Day, not Librarians Day, because libraries are only there when libraries are there. If no libraries, then no library. So it should be Libraries Day. And I think we should consider changing it National Libraries Day, not the Librarians Day. So what you are saying is very relevant, and I'm willing to help my young colleagues, and many time I have thought of it. I'm very, very eagerly looking forward to those youngsters who want to fight, who want to no need of any platform. Sometimes you don't need platform, you need only a kind of collective minds together, the people who have desired to do something good, they should come together. So from entire part of the country, like people who are really worried about the profession, they want to do something good profession, they should come together and slowly, slowly contribute in creating awareness at their district level. Like, take example of Panchayati Raj. There is an Article 73 clearly defined that every panchayat should have a library. So we should go to and ask the person, DM and the panchayat, head of panchayat, that why you have not created a library in that. There are small, small things. Like if in our college, the librarian's position is not full. And it is not just the role of libraries only. It is the responsibility of academicians. It is the responsibility of the general public to fight for the libraries, because ultimately they are the beneficiary. Librarians are getting only jobs, but you are getting career. You are getting your self-development is totally dependent upon the library. So my call to the entire public, entire academic community, entire research communities, there is a concept of friends of libraries in various countries. So we need a lot of friends of libraries. So we need to bring those policymakers. We need to convince our MLAs and MPs and pradhans, and then those the secretaries and those chairman of UGC and all those things. So somewhere, I think down the line, we need to make them convinced that libraries are not doing well, and it is because there's something wrong in our policy making and planning. Let's understand it. Don't kill the libraries. I think hope
satisfying your answer. We have a question that is, should library science be imparted through distance education?
My answer to this is that for a select professional, like suppose somebody has done library science, bachelor's library science, and he has joined the job and he want to further go for upgradation at master level course. I only recommend distance learning for the person who is working in the library, having some experience and want to go for higher education. I never recommend any distance learning course for the freshers, because librarianship is a very technical job. It required a lot of regular practice, a hands-on internship, and our distance learning courses are not providing that value addition. So there is something wrong in the mind of the educators and bombarding of education, the distance learning courses. It should be immediately stopped, except few universities. IGNOU is sufficient to provide such master's degree. I'm never in favor of having any graduation level degree in library science or correspondence courses. Master's can be there. PhD program and other things can be there with different models. But I'm against freshers doing distance learning and too many courses in distance learning. It has damaged our profession.
Thank you, sir. There is another question, and that is, should librarians have academic status or a faculty status? And since electronic media is taking over libraries, will a day come when librarians appointed eligibility of computer science will be necessary, or will have a library science degree? Your views, sir.
First, computer science. Yes, computer knowledge is very essential. Very, very, very. That is essential for every profession. You need not to be a computer programmer, so you don't require to learn computer science. And believe me, no computer science professional can become a librarian until unless he has library science background. So don't worry about that. Computer science person can take over your jobs, or they can be at no point of time, because computer information technology is having a role, but at the same time, abstracting, indexing, classification. See, what is BAB? BAB is all about indexing and abstracting. So until unless you know how to index good, what is the subject heading, keywords, all these are the domain and forte of librarians. So no professional can replace that forte. Even if it is 100% paperless libraries, There is no physical libraries. Even that scenario, there is a need for the libraries. So should not think in that line. Only thing is that we need to revise our courses according to the need of the IT. Like I have started a postgraduate diploma in digital library and data management at IGNCA, which is a 1-year course. So in that we are teaching all emerging technologies. So you have to understand that there is no possibility of anybody taking another thing, academic status and faculty status. You are an academician, you are a faculty. People give you status or not, librarian is a teaching or research person. Without, who are you? When a user is coming, first thing, what you are doing? Mentoring. You are guiding them, teaching them what are the resources good for his research, what are the references available. So you started your job with the mentoring, then you are listening. Then you are also educating them about different through information literacy and research literacy. You are teaching them various kind of how to search information, how to evaluate information, how to evaluate information. So you are already doing a job of a teacher. So why you can't be it? And I think it's a matter of only making it understanding. I think somewhere we are not able to have a good listening and convincing with our other faculty colleagues. We need to sit with them. We need to make them understand that it's not about asking for parity with you. Like a teacher of mathematics, he has done a PhD in mathematics and he become a teacher. Then a person who has done PhD in library science and he is a librarian, why he can't be an academician and researcher in that field? Because his subject is library science. Even a person in Hindi, who has done PhD in Hindi, is teaching a language. A person in Marathi or in Assamese, in any languages, that person is having that status of faculty and professor. Why a person library science itself is a subject recognized by the University Grant Commission. So then why there is a kind of mindset and differentiation? These things need to be convinced. They need to be, like, take example. I'm a person with library science background. I have done PhD in library science. And in terms of research, I have excellent ideas. I've been thousands of people I have guided in terms of how to improve the quality of research or visibility of research. I'm doing a job of a teacher. When I was in JNU, I was doing a job of teacher. Today, I'm doing a job of teacher plus librarian. So I'm doing a dual job. I'm doing administrative job as well as teaching or mentoring or a job which is. So it's the only matter of convincing. Because sometimes I think there's some kind of, because of our image in society, people are not aware that librarians have something else other than issuing books and returning books. That's a mindset. This is a public image. We need to change it. We need to convince the people that the research what we are doing is not less than the research a faculty in science are doing or in social science doing. We are doing the same amount of research work when we are talking, devising various kind of indexing techniques and services. We have been writing papers, we have been publishing and presenting papers in the conferences. Everything what a teacher is doing, what a researcher is doing, librarians are doing. It's only a matter of just making it clear to the people who are the decision makers. And many places it has been done. Many places when university is formed, there are 5 positions and university librarian is one of the position because they are considered the most important position and officers of the university. So I think this is a matter of just understanding, not an issue of debate.
I hope the participant is satisfied by your answer. There is another question. Should there be professional council like ICMR, ICAR, etc. for librarianship?
Good suggestion, but I have different opinion. Actually, I'm in favor of having, like, since many years I have been fighting that there should be a department of libraries under the ministry. Like currently what is happening? Libraries are divided under Ministry of HRD, Ministry of Culture, Ministry of Science and Technology and different ministries. There is no single department look after the needs of the libraries. So having a council may not serve the purpose because it is a matter of policy and guidelines. Under National Knowledge Commission, there was a recommendation to form a library commission. And under the library commission, they were supposed to have a center for excellence in teaching and education and also different projects and scheme. In that context, National Mission on Libraries was formed. So we have lost the track. Actually, what we should have that library commission in place by now. In 2007, 1200 crore was sanctioned by the government. But somewhere I think we are not able to save it. This is our fault. The bureaucracy killed that particular things and we were more mere spectator. So more than a council, I will recommend we should have a separate library commission or department of libraries, and all the libraries policies, guidelines and everything should come under single umbrella under a minister, which is separate secretary and other office wears, where library science people should be in the running of the affair as a joint secretary or something. So I have that proposal and that structure in mind rather than a council like ICMR.
Sir, I think we are running short of time, though we have many questions. We'd like to put up one last question. We know that library is the heart of any institution, but school library is not developed like college library and university library. What is the main reason for this?
The main reason for that, I blame it first, those controlling boards, CBSE or other state boards. I am a member of committee of CBSE on library matters, and I expressed this several times that please make guidelines where a school library should be must. And there are no proper guidelines that how a school library should function in a school. Many times, thousands of schools in these countries are without school librarians. So first is that the lack of proper attention from the controlling authorities. Second is the attitude and awareness among the principals. See, basically, they are not very well aware of the importance of the libraries. So sometimes even there is a librarian, he has been given other responsibilities rather than focusing on the libraries. So I think somewhere down the line, I propose to CBSE to organize a conference of principals where I propose that I will be happy to speak to them on need of a school library. I spoke in one of the principals conference which was organized by some private schools. So similarly, there is a need of awareness among the principals that libraries are having some different role. Then third important or the problem I see is the funding. There is no separate funding available for school libraries. And people believe school library's job is just to provide certain kind of textbooks and other books, which is not true. Actually, every student is having a textbook. What you provide in a school library is something additional reading material. I know that there's some problem with the library profession also. People have not understand the importance of library. Library is open from like school hours. When school hours classes are happening, who can come to the library? So library timing should be extended beyond school hours so the people who want to study in the library, they can come. Same time, librarians should design how to inculcate reading habit, storytelling sessions. Also, they should focus on organizing quiz, contests, book talks, book discussions. There are no library schools program. There isn't a proper training like specialization in school librarianship. So I think there are multiple reasons for the downfall of the library. And give you an example, the mindset of the government, like a notification was issued by the UP government in a few years before, prior to this government, that physical education teacher will look after the libraries. They will be in charge of the libraries instead of appointing a library. I think these are the multiple reasons for not having good state of libraries in school libraries.
I remember, sir, where, as a child, we had a reading period in school. I mean, like we were given books to read And again next week. I think that was the way we got into the habit of reading or going to the library. But today we see such classes are not there in any of the schools. To ask one very last question, you have said that internet is not library or not even a digital library. So a question related to that has come. How can we differentiate whether the information in the internet is authentic? So I would like to thank you very much while you answer this, and I'll hand over the microphone for the vote of thanks to our librarian, Deepika Das, while you answer.
Yeah, very, very important question, very valuable question. So what I suggest, librarians has to become a fact checker. They have to develop themselves in evaluating information, and there are various ways of doing it. Number one, all peer reviews journals published by reputed publishers are automatically authenticated information. Books published by various authors are authenticated information. Then there is other ways of, like suppose if you want to understand difference between predatory journals and open access journals. So you should learn how to differentiate between predatory journals and open access journal. Like example, both predatory journals and open access journals follow gold open access model. Now there are criteria. I deliver frequent talks on this. So librarians have to develop themselves how to identify a predatory publishing. Like they are not very well peer reviewed. Their website is not having complete details of the journal. Their names are written as an international journal, reputed journals. They always mention a leading publisher, although publisher is just 1 year old. So there are number of checks, and there is some list like Think. There is a database called Think, Act, and Check. So you can check the predatory journal in that. Then there is another like very good initiative by UGC. UGC care list of reference quality journals. So you must check that this journal, which is a predatory journal, should not be listed in that. So you can verify from that. Besides that, every publisher has some kind of databases. Like Elsevier has Journal Finder, Springer has a Journal Suggester. So like you need to tell the researcher that if you put your abstract and summary and title, you will be able to know which journal is suitable for your writing. Then to find out the information which is on social media, is it a fake information or not? There's a lot of focus. Google has fact checker. So there's a fact checker. You use that, learn how to do the fact checking. And there are a number of way of fact checking. Similarly, like if you want to know this image is fraud or real, there is an image detection softwares. So use image detection software. This itself is becoming a challenging profession. A librarian has to be versatile, multitasking, and a person with who understand nitty-gritty of web and how to deal with that, how to search, how to authenticate, what to provide most relevant information. Actually, modern librarians are supposed to be the knowledge navigators who need to guide researcher, students, faculty with the menace of this unwanted and undesirable and unauthenticated information. That's why I'm saying the role of librarians will be more and more relevant in coming years. So you need to prepare for that role, but you cannot prepare yourself without updating your knowledge, without becoming a good technology savvy person, without learning all those new technologies. First, you have to learn it. You need to revise your library science courses immediately and put all these plagiarism detection software, reference management tools, fact checkers, and everything, deep web search engines, everything in the syllabus. Then you become a real modern librarian, and then people will really respect you and regard you. So Samir, I think you need to do your homework and you need to do your job better. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your informative lecture and the valuable sharing. I am going to deliver my speech, that is vote of thanks. Good afternoon, everyone. I am honored and lucky to have the opportunity to give a vote of thanks on this special day. At first, I would like to thank Dr. Jitu Boraguhai, Principal, Dibrugarh College, and Dr. Nibedita Phukan, Principal, MDKLC College. Their positive support encourages us to organize this event. My heartiest thanks to Professor Ramesh Chandra Bose, sir, for giving confirmation as chief guest of this event within his busy schedule. I particularly liked Professor Ramesh Chandra Bose's speech, where he mentioned about the librarianship qualities of librarian, leadership qualities of librarian. I would like to thank all the family members of Dibrugarh College and MDKLC fraternity. I would like to thank Madhumita Borthakur ma'am for reciting the Gita slokas and Nandita Vaishya ma'am for moderating the program smoothly. I must not forget to thank Mr. Gunindra Bora and Mr. Vikas Tuti for their technical support, which makes the event a successful one. Last but not the least, I would like to thank the participants of this web talk for whom it comes through. Thank you all. The feedback will be given in WhatsApp group and through email, and certificate will be provided within this week. Now, the meeting is adjourned. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much, and have a good day, and have happy Labyrinth Day. Bye-bye.
Thank you, sir.